On June 24th, just 50 minutes after midnight, a swarm of earthquakes began striking adjacent to California's active Lassen Peak volcano, which last erupted in 1917. While these earthquakes were quite small, they kept occurring one after the other, unlike what would be expected in a typical foreshock or aftershock sequence. Across the next 8 hours, the rate of earthquakes continued to increase until it reached a peak at 8:50 a.m. local time, generating the largest event in the swarm, which could even theoretically have been felt, a magnitude 2.5. Activity then declined across the next 11 hours, involving about 36 more earthquakes until the swarm ceased altogether. In all, approximately 100 earthquakes had struck, which could technically be classified as volcanic in origin, marking this California volcano's largest such swarm in a decade. However, this swarm was not at all concerning, as it was not triggered by magma movement, but rather from heated geothermal fluids rising from underground. Generally speaking, the more extensive a volcano's geothermal system is, the more earthquake swarms of this variety it will produce. This is why the Yellowstone volcano in Wyoming, which contains the largest and most extensive geothermal system of any volcano on the planet, also experiences highly frequent geothermal earthquake swarms, which do not imply any suspicious activity. Since Lassen Peak contains the largest grouping of geothermal features in the Cascade Mountain Range, it too produces fairly frequent earthquake swarms, which, just like Yellowstone's, could be considered part of the normal background activity in a non-eruptive state. You can even see this pattern when I overlay a USGS map of every single historical earthquake which has been recorded in and a bit around of Lassen Volcanic National Park, as clusters of earthquakes occur adjacent to, albeit primarily just uphill of known hot springs, mud pots, and fumaroles. In the case of the latest earthquake swarm, which produced 17 events larger than magnitude 1.0, they occurred 3,700 to 8,500 feet away from the terminal geyser. Although magma is solidifying about 8.5 kilometers or 5.3 miles beneath Lassen Peak, it is still hot enough to transfer heat into groundwater following rain and snowfall events. This heated water then rises, along with some volcanic gases, into weak spots in the crust, lubricating pre-existing fault lines, which makes them more likely to slip. The earthquake swarm we just observed may have been directly linked to a heavy snowfall event which occurred on May 5th. A lesser earthquake swarm occurred essentially in the same area on October 31st of 2022, also approximately 7 weeks after a major precipitation event. As a result, Lassen Peak's alert level remains at green. However, although unlikely, it is possible that changes could occur to nearby hydrothermal systems as a result of this recent earthquake swarm. The larger earthquake swarm in 2014 caused the Morgan and Growler hot springs to output water at twice their prior rate, along with creating new patches where steam rose from the ground. The same thing could have technically occurred last month, although we have no evidence indicating that this hypothetical occurred. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel members and patrons on Patreon for supporting this channel.